Can continue on the next presentation by Ksenia Mitrofanova, I think, yes. And the title of the presentation is about regional internet competition in English skills among Russian speaking medical students, first experience. And Ksenia comes from the Ural, right? Yes, Europe. State Medical University from Russia, and she is going to share her experiences, okay. I think. Do you need help? Okay.
Okay, hello everyone. Let me share our experience from two universities from Russia. One university is the Ural State Medical University. It is in the Ural region. And the other one is Krasnoyarsk State Medical University, which is situated in the Siberia. And to begin with, I provide some information about my university. And we have four faculties, and general medicine faculty, preventive medicine faculty, pediatric care faculty, and dentistry faculty, and about 700 first-year students study now at our university. And first of all, what was our idea, why we decided to practice such an unusual experience about the competition in English skills in medical students, and why we found this very important. The problem is that our students teach study humanities only first 2 years in medical school. And as for English, medical English, they study only 1 year during the first year. And frankly speaking, that is the problem now, because after graduation, only 5% of our graduates, medical graduates, can really speak English and can, for example, present at the conferences, and about 95% of students have some writing skills, reading skills, but they have not enough experience in communication. And first of all, we want to enhance our students' motivation to study English for professional purposes, and to show how it is important for a medical professional in our world to be competent in medical English. And also, the other task was to stimulate collaboration between the universities and to find out whether it is possible or not to do such kind of projects. And the internet competition in English skills was organized and was organized during 2 months, September and October, and it was held during November and December. It took about 30 days. And the first stage was such kind of tests of different formats, multiple choice, drag and drop, open-ended questions. And the first stage was devoted to evaluation of reading, listening, some grammar and vocabulary skills of medical students. And about 130 participants from both universities took part in the first stage. And for the second stage, 35 best students from both universities were chosen. And the topic for the The task for the second stage of our competition was to make a video where they should speak on a certain problem, or not necessarily a problem, but an issue. And as they were first-year students, and it was their first semester, and we chose a topic that was like health is not simply the absence of illness, and they should develop their ideas and share their ideas on this topic. And as for the first stage, 10 best students, according to the assessment of three experts, were chosen for the last stage. That was a teleconference between our universities, and speak in details later about the first stage. So as for the first stage, all the tasks were placed on the university's platforms. One was of our university, the other was of Krasnoyarsk Medical State University. And sorry, most part it is in Russian, because we described how they should use that platform, what should they do, what should they pay attention to, and only the tasks were in English. And as for the second stage, what was really interesting, that the task was just provide us with a video. We did not specify what kind of video that should be. We just wanted to check and to evaluate their ability to speak English. And what we get was really amazing, because about 30% of our students, it is about 11 videos that we have received, were really amazing from the point of view of organization, from the point of view of scenarios. And our students showed their abilities, how they can do this just, I would say, ordinary task. And I received a permission from our student Kuchina Maria, and I want to show you one of the videos that was really interesting, I think.
Good afternoon, dear ladies and gentlemen. My name is Maria, and I think that I'm healthy, but am I right? What is health? Is health a state where one's body is simply free of disease, or is it something more complicated? To get a clearer understanding of this question, let's take a look at a person who physically is completely healthy. Let's call him Alan. Well, now, imagine for a minute that he hasn't got a proper education. He can't find a job he can enjoy. Finally, let's create another situation. We still have Alan, our physically healthy friend, and now he has a good job with high salary. Besides, there are many friends and acquaintances. But just look at him, look at poor Alan. He's so stressed that there are no antidepressants which can help. He is so diffident and deeply apprehensive that something in his life may go wrong. Can you call him a healthy person now? Perhaps the answer is rather no than yes. As can be seen, it isn't enough to be free of some illness to be healthy. Health is a state of complete physical, social, and mental well-being, and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. Actually, that is exactly how the World Health Organization defined the word health in 1948. So I wish you to be as healthy as possible, because a healthy person is a happy one.
Okay. That was one of the videos that we have received. We also received two songs that our students compose, and they sing them. And also there were several, I would say, films that have a certain scenario. Yeah? And that was really great because we found out that these kind of tasks not only are accepted by students, but they really find this task very interesting because they help them to show their individuality and to show their skills and abilities. And as we found out that our teachers' competence, for example, in technologies are not so high as our students have. And as for the third stage, it was a teleconference, and we connected with the other university using Skype, and also we have two experts on each from each part, I mean from our university and from the other. And here we evaluate the ability to communicate with the other person and the ability to express the views, their own views, and to share the ideas. And as for the conclusions and what we found interesting from this, our first experience, that first of all, students really enthusiastically accept new teaching methods that are not ordinary and that help them to develop their creativity, to show their individuality. And what is else in, very interesting, that most students found the way the conference was, or not conference, the competition was held, very interesting because it is it did not require personal presence. For example, at the university, they can do some tasks at home and they can prepare their works at home, and that was very convenient for them. And moreover, first-year medical students express their desire to be involved in such kind of projects, and we are happy to say that about 20% of the participants in this competition from my university are also now attending some elective courses in English. For example, we have such an anatomy in English classes, and they're really interested in studying English for medical, for professional purposes. And also some of them expressed their desire to present their future research in English at annual students' conferences. And moreover, these kind of projects helps to develop collaboration between the universities, and we also presented the results of our competition and of our practice at the first medical university in Moscow, and all the participants at this meet at that meeting said that they will be glad to participate next year in this kind of competition and to show their students that they have a possibility to show their talents not only in their profession but also some other skills and abilities. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Ksenia. Do you have any questions or comments for Ksenia's presentation? Yes, please.
Congratulations for your presentation. Do you think that your methodology can be applied for another kind of, I mean, okay, you apply it to medical students, but I mean, it would be useful for another kind of teaching? Or do you consider that there's any specific point that is specifically designed for medical studies?
Yeah, I think you mean the teaching purpose, yeah, of these kind of projects. Yeah, I think it is very useful because, first of all, we try to develop all the tasks that were in this kind of competition to make them professionally oriented. Of course, our first year students haven't got enough knowledge in medicine, but we still try to, for example, to use medical terminology, I would say general medicine terminology concerning medical education, medical service abroad, and I think that this kind of competition, yeah, that is great.
So it seems that the competition, the procedure of the competition is makes the students enthusiastic and not only the purpose that is to gain skills in English area.
Yeah, what is really important is to motivate them and to show, to show how can they use their knowledge and how can they apply their knowledge not only in medicine but in English and some other skills also.
Okay. Christina, do you have?
Just out of curiosity, you said that about 5% of the students are fluent in English. Is it because they prefer another foreign language, like French or Spanish, or?
No.
No, okay. Out of curiosity.
It is because of the education at school, I would say.
So we could make competitions for other skills. Okay, any other questions? Thank you very much, and wish you the best for the next competition.
Thank you.
Okay. Thanks.